This video is going to be about left-to-right addition. So let's look at a problem and try to understand this. Here I've got an addition problem. 736 plus 548. And I've written those two numbers one over the other with a plus sign. And I'm going to add them first in the way you probably learned to do this. So we'll go to the ones column. I've got a 6 and an 8. And I'll add those together, I get a 14. So I'll write the 4 underneath the 6 and the 8, and I'll carry a 1 into the tens column. Now adding up in that tens column, I've got a 1 plus 3 is 4, and 4 more will give me 8. And there's nothing to carry. And now I've just got to go to the hundreds column and add the 7 plus 5, which is 12. So I've got 1,284. Now, if you think about what I've just done, basically I started on the right side of both of those numbers, where the ones are. I added up what I had in the ones column, and then I moved to the left to the tens column, added those up, and moved to the left again to the hundreds column, added those up, and I got my answer. Even though I moved from right to left, when I read the answer from left to right. 1,284. So left to right addition is a way of doing the addition in the same order that I'm going to read the answer in. And here's how it works. I'm going to start in the hundreds column on the right side of each number. And I've got a 700 and a 500. So I'll add up 700 plus 500. That's going to give me 1,200. And I'll write that down underneath the original problem. Then I'm going to go to the tens column, and I've got a 30 and a 40. So I'll add together 30 plus 40. That's going to give me 70. And then I'll go to the ones column where I've got a 6 and an 8. So I'll add the 6 plus the 8. That's going to give me 14. I'll write that number in. And now I've just got to add up 1,200 plus 70 plus 14, and that's going to give me 1,284, the same answer I got before. Okay, so basically what I'm doing is I'm starting with my hundreds. If I had thousands, I'd start with the thousands. I'm starting with the biggest unit that I have. So I start with the hundreds in this case, add them together and get my 1,200. Then I go to the tens. I add those tens together and get a 70. Then I go to the ones, I add those together and get a 14, and I add those three numbers together to get the answer. So you might want to practice this a bit just to get used to it and see if it's comfortable for you. Now, if you do get good at this, you might want to try doing some mental arithmetic, mental addition, and here's how we would do the same numbers, just doing them mentally. So I've written them again, but I've written them on one line. Just 736 and then a plus sign and then 548 and my equal sign. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at these numbers starting from the left side of each number. Both of them start with hundreds, so I'll add those hundreds together. I'm going to have 700 plus 500 will be 1,200. Now I'm going to quickly look at the next numbers over, the 3 and the 4, and make sure that when I add them together, I'm not going to have any carrying involved. Well, 3 plus 4 is 7, so there won't be any carrying involved. So I can take that 7 and 5, the 700 and the 500, and write down 12, which is going to become 1,200, but I want to add more numbers to it. Then I'm going to the tens places. I've got a 3 and a 4, which is going to be a 7. But if I look over one more place, when I add up those 1s, the 6 and the 8, I'm going to be carrying something. I'm going to carry a 1 over. So I'm going to take that 3 and 4, which is 7, and add one more to it, the number I'm going to be carrying, and make that an 8. And then I'll go to my 1s, where I have a 6 and an 8, and I can add those together and get a 14. Now I already did the carrying part of that 14, so all I have to do is write a 4. Now this takes longer to explain than it does to actually do it. So when you get comfortable with this, you can more or less just look at this number, do just about all of it in your head, much faster than I can say it, and end up with that 1,284. Okay, so you might want to work towards that goal and then give that a try and see how good you can get at it. Okay, that's it for now. Take care and I'll see you next time.